idea that there would be that people keep talking about this about me, and it's not about me at all. It's about this kind of thing that all of us kind of came together in various times, in various ways, kind of did something special, and it kind of, there was an ebb and flow to the whole thing, but there was also kind of really neat things that happened.
Skip line.
Might have been a thankless job. I think.
Right, next. Yeah. Class of 72, next.
20 in the car. What's your 20?
20.
Never mind.
The crowd called out for more. Coming harder as the ceiling flew away. He called out for another drink. The waiter brought a tray, and so it was that
somebody
in the tube,
she must have said something.
Back. The face at first is ghostly, turned a whiter sheet of paper.
It was kind of a great weekend just to get together. It was, you know, a plethora of memories and great memories and really good, neat people. It was so much fun. It was just one of those things that you can't imagine how this would all come together again all these years later in such a neat way, and in such a way that so many of these people just picked up a conversation we had 30 years ago. This has just been amazing to get everyone together for this kind of a thing and to have so much fun and to see how many people have in all the years since Topeka, how they've prospered, how they've accomplished so much, and how they've done so many other really neat things. It's encouraging, but, you know, to me, not surprising. I mean, these people were all, they were all capable of doing something special, and they all did.
Thank you.
They did it. 3 months ago, Jeff Jacobson says to me, well, you know, photographers can't keep secrets. But you know, I said I was coming out here on this expedition with the Lankers and the Settles. And he said, well, you know, photographers can't keep secrets. What secret? Oh, nothing, you know.
Was in town.
Oh, that was classic. There was this guy at Dag's Pizza Hut, and we had gone over to, you remember we used to edit the and make all the prints for on the college football days on Saturday, and we would turn all that thing in. It would be about 7:30 in the evening, and now the page makeup wasn't going to be done until about 9:30, so we'd all go over to Dag's and have a beer and pizza, and then go back to start checking the position and everything on the picture page. So we're in there, and there's this Volkswagen bus parked in front, and this guy sitting at the bar, kind of sipping a beer. And we're sitting there, and we're talking about pictures, and finally this guy turns around and says, are you all photographers? Oh, yeah. He said, well, I'm a photographer, too. He says, I've been a photographer in New York for a number of years, and I was an assistant there, so I'm now going to Los Angeles to start my own business. So we said, well, that's very interesting. And I said, who did you assist in New York? He said, well, I was Ouija's assistant. Really? And what did you do for Ouija? And so he came up with a few things like that. And we just let him keep going on and on and on. And finally, I says, I think I have some bad news for you. You know, he thought he was talking to a bunch of country bumpkins and Topeka.
Well, he was.
Topeka? How would you think that?
So, I said, I think I have some bad news for you. He says, and what is that? I said, Ouija is dead. Ouija is dead? I said, yeah, Arthur Feely died 9 years ago. That guy took, remember this? Yeah. One more sip of this beer, sat down, didn't say a word, walked out.
I got some bad news for you.
Oh,
I have a front page story in the journal about the leader of the Kansas United Dry Forces, Reverend Roy Holloman. I spent the day with him.
God, I forgot all about
that. He wanted to ban planes using alcohol over the state.
Flying over. Alcohol being served over Kansas.
No drinks
on the way from New York to Los Angeles.
Over Kansas. So I go to interview this guy, and I write a decent profile turn in. You know, come in the office the next morning, and I'm just kind of sitting down at my desk, and all of a sudden Pete yells, "Tharp!" I go over to his desk, and he's got this white flat top, fingers missing, and looks up at me, straight from simple casting, looks up at me. "Got a front page story today, do you?" "Yes, sir." "Make you feel pretty good, does it?" "Yes, sir." "Think you did a good job on it?"
"I said,
well, I hope so." He said, "Yeah, you did a hell of a good job, except you misspelled his fucking name every fucking time you fucking used it in the fucking story." In the whole, you know, the whole newsroom saw me humiliated. And obviously, I never forgot the lesson. So I have not misspelled a name until today.
He was misspelled Claire.
Oh my God. A-I-R?
C-L-A-I-R.
God damn it. God damn it. You shit.
Don't you love it?
Toothbrush. Toothbrush.
Stay with the floor.
Well, he led into it. I wasn't going to say anything, but I mean,
I read it. Settle read it. Lanker read it.
Oh, good.
I wondered about it.
Did you?
Yes.
I should have known.
Oh, if you just called me.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Rich, what's your middle name?
Why?
Oh, nothing. How do you spell your middle name? Oh, nothing.
I thought about it, but I figured he's a newspaper editor.
Can you
possibly create
oh
these
my things? God, I just...
You gotta understand, you're old enough to know the makings of a man. Listen to me, baby, it's hard to settle down. Am I asking too much for you to stick around? Every boy wants a girl he can trust to the very end. Baby, that's you, won't you? Saying that you'll end up a fool. For the time being, baby, live by my rules. When I settle down, I want one baby on my mind. Forgive and forget, and I'll make up for all lost time. If she's put together fine, and she's reading my mind, thank you.
to write my diary of when I was competing for the U.S. team, track team, as a high school boy against the Soviet national team. He said, why don't you, you know, take a diary, and here's a camera, you can just take a few pictures. So when I came back, he looked at the diary and said, oh, this is okay. And then he looked at the pictures and he said, say, how'd you like a job? So, you know, he took basically what was somebody that didn't know what they were doing and, you know, transformed me into, you know, like all of you guys, you know, people that knew how to take pictures. But I started out on the sidelines of the KU football game taking pictures, and then eventually became an intern and then became a full-time staffer. So it all started with that simple process of here's a camera, let's see what you can do.
When I think back on all the crap I learned in high school, it's a wonder I can think at all. And my lack of education hasn't hurt me none. I can read the writing on the wall. Cold or throne.
Photo paper in the newspaper. No, not only. And I would go back and have a staff meeting and say, worst staff I ever.
Yes, you did.
I never thought we were anywhere close to being the top level. And the beauty of all of that at the time was we had both a PM newspaper and an AM newspaper. And what didn't get used right in the morning newspaper, we could figure out how to get it really recycled the next day. And there were all these kind of wonderful opportunities to use pictures well. But as you all know, one of the first things that I would talk to someone about coming to our staff is, okay, you're a photographer, fine. What I want you to do is to think like a picture editor. I want you to think every time you're going out on an assignment, think about how you're going to do this really well. And how you're going to give some flexibility to the pictures that you've done. If it's a setup, shoot both a vertical and a horizontal. Clean up the backgrounds. get the graphics right, do all of these other kinds of things. And it was so simple to do that. And then after some of you had been there for 9 months or a year or something like that, I said, okay, now think like the managing editor. Think how you could be most effective in getting your pictures on the page that mesh with the stories of the day and don't come in with some god-awful idea for doing something on a day that the newspaper only had 16 pages on Monday morning. Don't save those ideas to do that until such time as A, it's a larger paper of the day, and B, there's nothing else going on, big time news that's going to dominate the front page. You want a front page picture? It's not just a matter of doing like Brian did all the time, taking a cup of coffee to Mac.
You did that.
And say, yeah. I have solved your page one problem. And then at that point, Brian would go put the film in the developer, and then would come back out and see Mac again and say, this is really going to be pretty good. I mean, this really meshes with the news today, and I've got all this going. So then he'd take the film out of the developer and put it in the hypo, and he'd go out and see Mac again and say, yeah, this is turning out really well. Then they get the negatives in larger and start making prints, you know, and starting with 8 columns and then 7 columns and 6 columns. So he'd take one of these out to Mac and say, well, here's how you're going to make page one just look like gangbusters in the morning. And Mac would say, well, I can't have a 5 column picture. And Brian would say, well, actually, here's the 4 column version. And it can't really read well on anything less than this. But it was really kind of amazing the way we went about doing all those things. But basically what I was trying to tell you all, and you got it, was think like someone that's a user of pictures and think like someone who is a reader of pictures. I used to remember Stan Stoffer would get me cornered in the hallway. He says, now, why is this a good picture? Oh, shit, how dumb can a publisher be? So I would try to explain that to Stan, and he would nod. And you know, that went on for several years. Every now and then he would say, well, actually, that was a really good picture this morning. Oh, well, I thought so too. Why did you think so, Stan? And then he would start to tell me. And I thought, oh, shit. But then at a certain point, you know, like a young guy that starts to grow up and suddenly discovers the parents may know something, I suddenly discovered that the publisher knew something. The publisher was very much like our average reader. And it, the things that he would like would be... that you want to pay attention to that. And one of the things that he liked all the time was to see where something happened. I mean, there was an error in there that we always thought about cropping to the 2-column, the 3-column, and getting to the content. Stan loved pictures that were wider, that showed where something happened.
Mama, take my coat from.
would have ever gotten involved in this whole bizarre life?
Jesus. From starting that newspaper in your basement.
I could have been an insurance salesman. I could have been an aviator and crashed by now.
Well, you were close enough to several. That one span was twilight zone.
In 1 year, I witnessed 3 airplane crashes.
I mean, that's photographed.
Luckily, I was in none of them, but I photographed them. So whatever.
We're dropping down from the high altitude. We then these pictures of Tuttle Creek, where we're dropping down. I look down, and I say to our pilot, the son of the guy that used to run Capital Air Service, so, look, there's a constellation Gabriel Land at the airport. And that's why they extended this runway. So, let's take a picture of this going down. So, he's banking and pulling rain and letting down. And we see this constellation crash. They land short of the runway, share off the landing gear, then all at once, here's this constellation zooming down the runway with both wings breaking off and the 4 engines cascading down the runway.
Wow.
Pretty good pictures. Then finally comes to stop and it's all breaking into.
Is this in front of you?
In front of me.
Oh, man.
I'm photographing this goddamn thing. We photograph all this from the air, and I tell our pilot, Oakley, land. You know, so he lands, and now we're landing so close, we get...
Gotta get out of here.
There were no fatalities. We get all the troops of the charter for Fort Raleigh troops getting off the airplane, and all their wives were waiting for them, and they were all hugging, and all the airplane is burning out in the background. And my favorite picture of the whole thing was the captain and the co-pilot are standing in front of the burning wreckage, and they're going like this.
You remember that picture?
Yes.
It's a classic picture. The plane has crashed.
They're trying to figure out, you know.
We're now taking off to head back to Topeka, so I'm now calling in to the office. And Jim Peters is on the phone, on the radio.
Same Jim Peters.
And he says, we've been trying to get a hold of you. There's a plane crash at Manhattan.
So what do you say to them?
I just photographed it. I'm on the way in with the pictures. And he's sitting there, and Owen Brewer was standing there, and Owen Brewer says, I don't understand how this happens. I don't understand how he could do this. And Peterson turns to him and says, no girls.
You move me.
any rate, they were good years, which you all know. I don't want to get emotional, but this was really pretty neat this week. I really appreciate it. So thanks to all of you for everything you did.
Take you to the hotel, get your tie, and come back.
Right. But you know, when you're working a midship, you don't know what it's going to be.
Rich.
Cheers.
We appreciate you kicking us in the ass, teaching us how to kick ourselves in the ass, teaching us how to kick other people in the ass.
Being an asshole.
Which is necessary at times.
We respect you. We like you most of the time. And we always love you.
Amen.
The Rich.
Never mind.
Can we just go through that one?
It would be hard to know.
Just as hard to know.
I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you, and so I beg you, let it be me. Don't take this heaven from one. Cling to someone now and forever. Let it be me. Each time we meet, love, I find complete love.
see. I've thought oftentimes that you're still living in Albuquerque.
No, we're getting back to Tulsa. We've been back in Tulsa for 2 years now.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the last I heard, you were in Albuquerque.
We were in Albuquerque for 11 years.
Yep.
It was a great place to live.
Is it okay to give them your address?
Yeah, you can give them my contact address.
Okay, we're going to do that.
Yeah, I'd love to get in touch again and discuss the state of the world.
Well, good. That sounds good to me. Well, go have fun, and as I said, I wish I was there.
Well, I wish you were too, but this has been fun to do this, and we will continue the dialogue, as they said.
That's right.
Thanks again.
That's okay. Right. Take care, guys.
All right. See you soon.
See you. Thanks, Susan.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
The minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throne and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the
It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
there was a time when you let me know what's really going on below, but now you never show that to me, do you? But remember when I moved in you, and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew is hallelujah, 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 not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Thing started. Jeff Jacobson wrote a column for his blog about he and I getting into trouble back at Rich's house one night when Rich came on and heard us on the radio, and we were laughing about it. He sent the blog to me, and so he said, "Yeah, you know, it'd be great to get together. We ought to do a reunion or something." And I said, "Look, I've said that so many times. We're doing it. That's it. It's happening. We're not going to put it off another year. We're not going to just have idle talk about it. We're doing a reunion." So I just took the ball and ran with it.
That sounds right.
Long may
missed that shift on the long decline.
Long may you run. Long may you run. Long may you run. Although these changes have come, with your chrome heart shining in the sun, long may you run.
Maybe the Beach Boys have got you now, with those waves singing Caroline.
Oh, Caroline, no.
Rolling down that empty ocean road, get into the surf on time.
Long may you run, long may you run, although these changes have come, with your chrome heart shining sun. Long may you run.
And my point of view is two things. One, not only did Rich deserve this, but all of you deserve this.
Right.
Because you were the part of something incredibly special. And it shouldn't be blown off. It shouldn't just be done in a haphazard or halfway way. You guys all deserve so much. And if you look at that book, that's an incredible book of photography that talks about your ability, your dedication, and what together as a family we've all created. And so, and we thank Rich for that.
Yeah, this is kind of the best idea of all. Yeah. Not that you didn't have other good ideas.
Just a couple.
Yeah, you told me they were great at the time.
You didn't know.
Yeah. But, you know, this is pretty good.
Yeah.
I might have a place for that. It won't be in the bathroom.